confirmation Sunday, and so Connor Copenhagen will be confirmed today, and so we look forward to having that be part of our service. Otherwise, I think it's pretty much standard fare as far as announcements. You know, we'll be talking about a few things coming up, hopefully with Bible school this summer and some other activities that we'll plan. It's hard to believe, you know, that here we are about halfway through the month of May. And so kind of keeps rolling along. But we're glad to be here today. We're glad to have the opportunity to worship with one another. Is there anything that anybody can think of that actually needs to be announced as far as announcements? Birthday?
Yes.
Yes, it was Justin's birthday. Oh, it is today? Okay, so we got some happy birthday, Justin.
Thank you.
praying for rain, and I'll keep praying for rain. So hopefully one of these days, it'll come. So we'll see what happens. We'll keep praying for that. We'll keep, you know, remembering the tragic state of the world in which we live, the Middle East right now. It's just so sad to see what's going on over there and different places. And hopefully, things will continue to keep improving as far as the pandemic. We're getting more of the restrictions loosened here. They tell us in a couple weeks and things, so keep remembering that. And of course, today is Connor's Day with confirmation, so we're going back to that. All right, let's join in our opening prayer. A noble God, on this most special day, you drew Jesus to your side, promising his companion spirit, power, permission, and purpose, calling his disciples to trust the future that they could not yet see. As we look to Jesus today, give us the same hope of spirit, power, permission, and purpose, and call us to trust the future that you too are yet unable to see. Guide us into your best, and give us the spirit of work in our lives. Reveal your truth and empower us to hear the witness of the risen Christ. We pray in the name of Christ, your mystery, your wisdom, our glory. Amen. Let's go down now in the spirit of reflection and prayer. Lord, we are so grateful to be here on this Confirmation Sunday. We pray for your blessings upon the service. Upon us all. We pray for rain to renew the earth. We pray for the Middle East and our world, which is so fragile. Bring peace, bring grace, bring promise and hope. May your love find a way to shine through and encourage in a way that only you are able to. Help us live here in a community of Dexter truly as your people. Help us to be light and salt to those around us, the genuine live of our faith, as we pray now that prayer that you have taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
So what are some of the things that you put in a treasure chest?
Jewels.
What? Jewels, yeah.
Gold.
Money.
Money.
Yeah, so you put in valuable stuff, right?
Diamonds.
Diamonds. So, you know, today is basically a special day. It's Confirmation Sunday. And to me, sometimes you have to think not only about things like gold and jewels, but the moment. And today shouldn't be just a special day for Connor, but should be a special day for all of us. So let's pray. Lord, there's a lot of things that we treasure and we value, and we just pray that today will be a special day for everybody. Help us to see the joy of what confirmation is all about, what your grace is all about, what your love is all about, as we offer this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. participated in the building up of the body of Christ. May justice and peace prevail. Let us give generously of our time, talents, and resources to foster this mission. At this time, we are invited to bring and offer your gift at any collection points. Our scripture today is from the book of Acts, chapter 1, verses 1 through 11. This is the ascension of Jesus up into heaven. And it begins, in my former book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and to teach, until the day he was taken up to heaven. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen, after his suffering, he presented himself to them and gave many convincing proofs that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." Then they gathered around him and asked him, "Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" Jesus said to them, "It is not for you to know the time or dates the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, and in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." After he had said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. They were looking up intently into the sky as he was going, when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. "Men of Galilee," they said, "why do you stand here looking into the sky? The same Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven." May God bless this reading of the Holy Word. Well, COVID impacted a lot of things, and one of the things it did was I like to exercise at the YMCA in Austin. And so for a while, of course, the YMCA, a lot of things were shut down, and I couldn't go there. And so I got really excited when they reopened it, and they actually said they were even going to have some classes again, and I'd like to take the classes, cycling, things like that. And so they even said, "Well, we're going to reopen, we're going to have classes." I was really excited until I found out that they were only going to have one class I wanted to take, and it was at 5:30. 5:15 in the morning. And I'm not a morning person. I never have been. I probably never will be. But it's important enough for me to be able to go to that class. So somehow I, for the most part, have been able to get up and get over there and still exercise. Well, this last week, I went down to Austin. And I was getting ready to take my class like I normally do, you know, bright and early at 5:15 in the morning. But I walked into the YMCA, and the guy behind the desk says, "Well, what are you doing here?" And I was like, "Well, no, I was like puzzled, you know." And I said, "Well, what do you mean, what am I doing here? It's no time to take my class." He said, "Well, your class just got done." I said, "What? What do you mean my class just got done?" And so then I figured out what had happened. You see, basically, a snooze alarm is only as good as the person who operates it. And usually what I kind of have a habit of doing is, you know, I got set early enough that, you know, I hit that snooze alarm, and then, you know, I hit it again, you know, and then I finally get up. Well, for whatever reason, that didn't work. And so I just got up with my normal routine, didn't pay attention to the time, and ended up getting to Y just in time to see that my class was done. So now I'm up, you know. I mean, I drove all the way to Austin, so I figured I should probably do something. So I ended up walking around the track for about a half hour and telling everybody why I missed my class. So, you know, so now I'm up. Well, today's Confirmation Sunday, and, you know, it's a turning point. You know, it's a big day in a lot of ways, not just for Connor, but really, I think, you know, for all of us. If you look at this passage of Scripture today, you know, basically, this is the ascension of Jesus into the heavens. You know, he's going to be with God. He had been appearing to his disciples. The disciples had witnessed the crucifixion of Jesus. They had seen the wonder of empty tomb and Easter Sunday, and on a number of occasions, every once in a while, Jesus would kind of pop in and announce himself to his disciples and talk with them. And basically, Jesus is saying, that's not going to happen anymore. You know, you're not going to see me in the physical presence like I am now. You know, that's not going to keep on going on. And I'm going to go ascend, go up into heaven and be with God. And so we have basically the disciples looking up into heaven as Jesus ascends. And you have, you know, Moses would probably say two angels appear saying, you know, why are you looking up in the sky? Why are you looking up into heaven? You know, because basically, you know, Jesus is gone. Well, that moment is another turning point. Because basically, as the days go on, the book of Acts, the whole book of Acts is about the birth of this thing called the church. You know, and that's what the disciples do. After Jesus ascends and goes into heaven, they go out into the world and they proclaim the gospel, and they begin the church. Well, for Rochelle, she had gone through a lot of things that a 10-year-old child should not have to experience. But thankfully, you know, she had some really good teachers who were very sensitive and, you know, tried to do everything that they could to make things better for some of the challenges that she was going through. And so one day, Rochelle came into school, and one of her teachers, Mrs. Cohen, you know, kind of sensed that you know, she needed to kind of check in with her. She did this from time to time. And the teacher found out that this 10-year-old was having to walk her younger siblings home from school. And she felt really uncomfortable about this, and she said, you know, I think that's too much responsibility. So I'll tell you about Rochelle. If it'll be okay, I think I can get a chauffeur for you and your younger brother and sister, so you don't have to walk home after school, and you can have a ride, and that way I feel a lot more comfortable. Well, you know, Rochelle was kind of a little bit resistant to this, but, you know, she agreed, and then she got to meet the person that would be her chauffeur, who was a young woman named Evelyn. And basically, Evelyn would pick her up and her rest of her family and take them home after school. And, you know, they would just kind of, you know, be able to have, you know, a neat ride. And she'd bring treats and talk and stuff. And it was kind of a neat little thing. course, sometimes Rochelle will complain about stuff, so we're teachers and things. Evelyn would just kind of smile and not say a whole lot about that. And it turned out that actually Evelyn was Mrs. Colin's daughter. But she had basically tried to keep that little fact hidden because she didn't want to make it uncomfortable, so she didn't say anything. And the neat thing was, though, is that the next year came, and Evelyn continued to chauffeur Rochelle and her siblings, and it became much more than that. As time went on, when Rochelle graduated from high school, who was there but Evelyn, and not just simply high school, but other things. When Rochelle got married and those kind of things, Evelyn was there for all those things. Here 27 years later, they're still, in contact with one another. Now Rochelle a lot of times takes the lead and makes sure that she, stays in contact with Evelyn. But that's what it's about, is this interconnection and this, being together and doing these things with one another. And, today is, Confirmation Sunday. And it's an important, Sunday for anybody that goes through that process of confirmation, what they go through. But really, it's just not the confirmation Sunday. It's our Sunday. Because the reality of the promises that are made and, the things that we talk about here today, that doesn't end today. That keeps going on from this moment. And basically that's what these angels are saying to, the disciples that have gathered there is that, you need to go back to Jerusalem and get ready. Because we've got this thing called the church, and you have a ministry. And so this is not an ending when Jesus just disappearing into the heavens. It's the beginning. It's the start of the church. It's the start of you to be able to bow into this world and proclaim the gospel. It's a chance for you to have your ministry to share the good news. And so that's what today is really all about for all of us is that, we're the hands and the feet of Jesus in this world. And it's not just simply for, Connor, but for all of us to realize that our ministry continues today. It's just taking a new step. It's just taking a new beginning. It's continuing on. And we're just, together, all of us, we're going to be able to be the church. Together. Let's pray. Lord, as we look at the ascension of Jesus into the heavens, it was just a new phase, a new opportunity, a new fresh start. You maybe wouldn't be appearing to the disciples as you had in your earthly presence, but you were still there. And it's still time to be about the work of this thing called the church. And so help us today to realize that all of us have an ongoing opportunity to share and ministry, to be with one another, and to be a part of this special thing that you call the church. To share and proclaim a message of good news, of love, and hope to our world. To live our faith as your people, all of us, as we offer this prayer in your name. Questions. And the way it worked then was that if you couldn't answer the questions, you didn't get confirmed. It's changed a lot, and hopefully in a lot of good ways. But, it's still important to realize that this is a journey. And so I asked Connor to do is I gave him two questions. And basically, those two questions are, why do we about that? That's the first question. The second question is, why is church important? So So I'm going to ask him to come up, and I think you probably should come up to the pulpit and take off his mask so people maybe can hear. But, you know, just read those questions, Connor. Just read your response to your book.
Why is church important? I believe that church is important because it is a place where you can express your Christianity and is a place where you are always welcome and is a place where you can ask for forgiveness from God. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated in Christ's Holy Church. We are incorporated in God's mighty act of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us without price. Through confirmation and through the reaffirmation of our faith, we renew the covenant declared in our baptism, acknowledging what God is doing for us, and affirming our commitment to Christ's Holy Church. I present Connor Russell Copenhagen for confirmation. Connor, on behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin?
I do.
Do you accept the freedom and the power that God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression, in whatever forms they present themselves?
I do.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races?
I do.
All right, now, congregation, I'm going to ask that you join with me in the part of this which is the affirmation. So just kind of follow along. Do you, as Christ's body in the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? We do. We nurture one another in Christian faith and life and include Connor now before you in your care.
With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround Connor with the community of love and forgiveness, that he may grow in the trust of God and become faithful in his service to others. We will pray for him that he may be true disciples who walks in the way that leads to life.
Let us join together in professing the Christian faith contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
You believe in Jesus Christ.
I believe in Jesus Christ, the Holy Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius
basically skip ahead to page 37, and if you look at the top of page 37, one of the things that we normally used to do is that we would lay on the hands. Well, we live in a COVID age, so we're not going to do that with me doing, you know, that. But what I want everybody to do, if you're willing to do this, is put out your blesser, as I call it. And we are all, at this point, going to have our prayers over Connor at this time. And so, Connor, the Holy Spirit work within you, that being born through water and the Spirit, you may be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. All right. And what I want to do at this time, I've got it up here. This is a certificate which has the church picture on it and a little bit of a remembrance of today, which you can take with you and just keep and recognize. power of God's Holy Spirit.
We have been made one in unity.
Even as we go our separate ways,
we go in unity and love.
We go to serve in love.
With the power of the Holy Spirit.
We go with the blessing of our community.
Guide our steps and protect our path.
Amen.
Our closing is to my
I know. just like, congrats.